Hey guys, my name is Sharel. I'm account manager at Nomadz, and today I want to show you a case study on how we managed to grow brand on Walmart and how to start advertising in Walmart. So let's dive in. So a cool thing that we can do in Walmart and we can do in Amazon is actually a comparison. I want to show you a comparison from the day that we started to work with this brand and also the 2 months prior to this. So we can see that we managed to grow ROAS by 24%, we managed to decrease spend by 17%, and we managed to increase sales by 2.4. I'm going also to show you the same date from last year, just for the comparison. As you can see, the same month from last year, 2023, we still managed to grow sales by 31%, although we spent a bit more, but as you can see, we managed to increase much more sales. Now, the main thing in Walmart that is, or I'm not aware of Amazon, is that you actually in Walmart can bid on yourself. What does it mean? If you create too many campaigns with the same product, actually the CPC will go up only because you are bidding on yourself. Now, as you can see, Walmart is pretty simple. It's like Amazon 10 years ago. We have the campaigns, the keywords, I'm going to touch about it, the keyword planner, the rules, and the reports. So in the campaigns, you actually can see the graph of the sales, and you can see that the campaigns that you already have. When we're creating a campaign, we need to add the name of the campaign. We have sponsor product, sponsor brand, sponsor video, similar to Amazon. The sponsor brand and videos, for some reason, is much more expensive than Amazon, and the starting bid is $0.3. And from our experience, actually sponsor product doing much better. Two tips: the automatic campaign with all the products in it actually doing the best. If you will create an automatic campaign, add all your products in low bid, you will see that it actually generating the best results. And the second one that we found that actually doing the most amount of sales, it's manual on broad phrase or broad and phrase together. The reason is because Walmart is so much smaller than Amazon, you need to have more keyword because each keyword have less search volume, and when you have many keywords, you will have for each keyword 1-2 sales, and you can see it in when you will check the last 30 days, you can see that actually you have many sales but in many different keywords, unlike in Amazon that you want to have 10 keywords, even 1 keyword in exact in order to push. Second thing is the day, the start day. Usually I'm just leaving it as it is. The total budget, usually I'm doing the daily limit just so the campaign will run. Here I'm going to tag everything on because again, Walmart is smaller than Amazon, so we want to appear everywhere. We have the placements. I'm going to touch about it in next videos. The next thing is to create the ad group. So as you can see, we can choose the name. Then we can add the items. If you're doing auto, like I said, you should put all the items here as all to all, and if you're doing a broader phrase per parent, you should add here the item of one of the child, and then you can actually add all of them together as one parent. And again, it's super important to not create too much campaigns for one product because you will see that actually you're going to a bid on yourself and the CPC will go up. So basically you're going to a bid war against yourself, and we don't want to do it because then the tacos will go up and we will have the same amount of sales. Second thing, we tested many keywords. We used to take the best keyword from Amazon. We used to do data dive Helium 10 to find the keyword, but we found out that actually Walmart keyword planner, so basically if I will add a random ace in here, for example, if you will add items, Walmart will give you the suggestion keywords, as you can see. And like I said, unlike Amazon here, as many keywords you can put, it's better because each keyword will have low search volume. So if I'm going to add all the keywords, for example, in broad, add keyword, broad, it's automatically in the suggested bid. Here, I can actually tag all the keywords that I added and decide which bid I want to have. After this, after I decided the bids, I decided the items, decided the name, the budget, and the name of the campaign. You can click save and then launch. And that's it. Basically, like Amazon 10 years ago. Two more features that I wanted to show. So we have the campaign manager, all the campaigns, we have all the keywords. So basically here is like the tab targeting. You can see for all of your keywords, the graph of ROAS, spend, sales, sales, and you can actually go to all filters, and here you can filter your keywords by ROAS, ad spend, CPC, clicks, and in this way it's easier to do big changes. For example, I can lower the bid. For example, if I will take all the keywords with less than 2 ROAS, first of all I will have the graph of them, and I can see that actually the ad spend is going up a bit, and I can also, in press of a button, adjust their bid. So basically I can decrease the bid, increase, I can close those keywords, I can decide which, how much keyword I wanted to do this. I suggest to look at the 7 or 14 days period for these big changes, and that's it. Very basic, very easy. Keyword planner is basically similar to the campaign when Walmart showing you the keywords. You can actually in the keyword planner item, and it will show you the best keyword for it. It's still not like the brand analytic in Amazon. You're still lacking a lot of data, but it is helping you to have better decisions and lower your ROAS and lower your TACOs, and in the end, increasing your sales. Now, the best tool that I think Walmart have and Amazon for some reason don't have is the rules. So you don't need any software to actually manage your Walmart account. You can actually create rules within Walmart. So the software will know how to increase or decrease bid based on condition in order to improve your account. So for this example, we have increase bid rule. So I'm going to enter to this rule just so we can understand it. So we have the name, the action. So we can choose variety of actions. Here I chose increase bid, the measure, percentage or dollars. So I chose 12, and the max bid is 0.8. So basically this is the when the software will know when to take action. The compare value, I wanted to see, here basically is the action, what you want to do, and here is the performance, when the software is going to, or why the software is going to do it. So we can put average ROAS, spend, impression, click, conversion rate. I like to go with ROAS in Walmart. So ROAS is greater than 4.2. The type I usually doing it by ad group, all ad groups, identify and compare from last 7 days. Occurrence weekly. So basically every week the software will check the last 7 days, and if the ROAS is greater than 4, they will increase the bid by 12% until the max bid will reach. So again, it's amazing. You don't need any software. You don't need anything. You can do it in Walmart. And in this way, actually, for the long run, you can have always make sure that your ROAS are high. That's it. So basically, we have also the reports. In Nomadz, we're using the organics in the Seller Central, in Walmart Seller Central, with the Walmart PPC to kind of have the better look of the total account, the organic with the PPC. But the most important thing in Walmart, again, is to make sure that when you're creating campaigns, you're not getting into bid war against yourself. So like I said, low amount of campaigns, a lot of keywords, low bid, and the most important, auto with all the products. I hope this video is helpful. Let me know in the comments if you want me to share more insights about Walmart, and thank you so much.